हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय नेम इज़ तौफीक एंड यू वाचिंग माय चैनल ग्राफिक्स देन। सो आई एम अगेन हियर एंड आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू माय कोरल रॉ क्लासेस फॉर बिगिनर्स। सो इन द लास्ट वीडियो आई ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन यू द बेसिक कंसेप्ट ऑफ कोरल रॉ एंड गेव यू एन इंट्रोडक्शन टू कोरल रॉ वेयर आई डिस्कस्ड हाउ टू क्रिएट अ न्यू डॉक्यूमेंट एंड आई ऑल्सो एक्सप्लेन्ड सम ऑफ द features of CorelDRAW. So in this video we are going to go ahead a bit further and I'm going to show you some of the features in the CorelDRAW. So first of all, as I showed you in the last video, we can create any shape and we can fill color by using left click and fill color, and right click you can change the outline color. Now I'm using the 2020 version of CorelDRAW. There might be something different, a slightly different way in the newer version, CorelDRAW 2021, but in the older versions these are the basic methods to change fill color and the outline color. Now as I mentioned in the last video also, that we have different properties for different shapes. Like these are the property for a rectangle tool, these are properties for the rectangle tool, and we select, when we select elliptical tool, we have different properties. So let us explore some of the basic properties of the basic shapes, because these are basic shapes. So when you select a rectangle, we have these four blocks, main four blocks, and we have a lock or link symbol in the middle. So these four corners of the rectangles are linked together. If we turn this off, we can see the unlink button. Then these are independent now of each other. These work separately once we break the link. We can again activate the link by clicking on the same icon. So these all four corners will act together because they are linked. We also have some other options, but let us begin with this option. So if you want to increase roundness of the corners, you can simply increase from here, or you can simply put any value or insert any value that you want. Simply drag. So as you can see, four corners are changing together, but I'm keeping it to zero again, setting it to zero. Now if I unlock this, then we will get separate effects for each corners like this, and we can create some simple shapes designs only by using these options. Again I am changing it to zero. I hope you are understanding. These are the basic options, lock and unlock. Now what if instead of roundness you want some different property? What if you want a scalloped corner? Then you can select this option, scalloped corner, and if you increase, now remember the link is on or the lock is on. If I increase any of the corners value, then all values will be changed. So this is the scalloped corner, and if you want chamfered corners, then you can also choose chamfered corner. Simply increase, you can chop and change between these three. Whatever effect you are looking for, you will get it: round corner, scalloped corner, or chamfered corner. So these are the basic properties of a rectangle. Now if you go to an ellipse tool, we have some different properties, such as a pie. Then this circle will be converted into a pie. Let me fill it with some color as you click, and if you change these values, you can see the changes in the ellipse. And if I choose this particular option, then it will be converted into an arc. You have to remember these options. If you are not looking for an arc option, then you can simply change it to ellipse, so that it will be converted into a normal ellipse. So these are some properties of some of the basic shapes. Like this, we have some different properties. For example, for the this polygonal tool, And if you want to change the values of the corners or the sides, you can simply decrease or increase the value from here. And if you want to, remember one thing, if you want to create an equilateral triangle, simply choose three sides and press and hold the control key, so you will get equilateral triangle. And similarly, if you want a circle, a perfect circle, then you have to press and hold control key or command key if you are using Mac. So this is control and drag, left click, so you will get a perfect circle. But even if you don't get a perfect circle, let's say you create an oval and you are looking for a perfect circle, now you can simply change these values, make these values similar, let's say 230 by 230, then it will be converted into a circle. So that is not a big deal, you can always change it. Similarly, you can do this for all the tools. And as we know, we have a star, we also have different properties for star, we also have common shapes. And in star, before that, in star we have couple of options, like a complex star. You can choose a complex star. So this is a complex star and this is our normal star. Now we also have some other shapes, common shapes, like this. These are some common shapes that are used in designing, like arrow shapes. And for arrows, we also have some changes that we can make by using these points. We have multiple points like this. If I choose this particular option, then we have multiple options like this. You can, and these there are different colors, because these different colors denotes different properties, that's why they have different colors. All other properties are same. Now if I go into the same category, common shapes, we also have some like common smiley face, sad face, we also have some banner shapes, we also have some call out shapes like this. And remember one thing, this is a very basic thing. If you want to zoom onto any particular section, you have to simply scroll the middle mouse button. Let's say if I want to zoom in onto this particular section, then I'll create a small circle over here, and let's say I want to zoom into this circle, then I can simply put my cursor over here and I can simply scroll the middle mouse button forward. Remember, forward is for zoom in, so I'm zooming in by simply forwarding the scroll or rotating the scroll mouse button. And if you scroll it towards you, it will be zoomed out like this. Zoom in, scroll forward, scroll backward is zoom out. And if you lose your page for some reason, this can happen initially, then use this simple shortcut key or the hotkey to get your view back. So shift plus F4, shift plus function key F4, so it will be fit to your page, or it will bring back your page. If you lose it by some for some reason, simply press shift plus F4, then it will bring back your shape view, or the page view rather. Remember, zoom in, scroll, and scroll backward, zoom out, shift F4, fit to window. Remember these for beginning, you know, when you begin these options, these are very useful hotkeys to remember, because you can easily lose your page by scrolling too much. So remember this shortcut key, shift plus F4. So these are some basic properties. And remember, to zoom into any particular area, just take your cursor or your pointer on that particular area that you want to zoom and simply scroll. You can zoom as much as you want, zoom out, shift plus F4. And some other basic things, if you want to select some of the shapes, let's say if I want to select this shape, I can simply click on this. Or if I want to select this tool or this shape, I can simply click on this thing. But remember, if you want to select by this particular method by drawing a rectangle around it, then remember you have to draw the rectangle all over the shape that you want to select. You cannot half select the shape, it won't be selected. So you have to cover entire area, only then it will get selected like this. Even if I select 90% of the area like this, it won't be selected. So you have to make sure that the entire area is covered under the rectangle that you are creating. So this is another way of selecting like this. And if you want to select multiple objects, this is one method. And let's say if you want to select random objects, let's say if I don't want to select this shape, you can simply click shift, press and hold shift button and again click. So whatever random objects you want to select, it will get selected, or they will get selected. Beg your pardon. So this is one way to select, or some methods to select objects. And you can, if you want to delete, simply press delete key after selecting the object, press and delete. Again I am going to create a rectangle. I am going to color it. Now remember these options. So there is another tool by using which you can perform similar thing. There is option called as, or the tool called as, the shape tool. If I choose the shape tool, I can perform similar actions that I want to use shape tool. But what if I want to change the entire shape? Then I have to press a shortcut, Control Q or Command Q, or right click on the shape and convert to curve, Control Q. So it will be converted into a curve. So we can change it to any shape that we want by using the shape tool, which is present over here. Shape tool. Remember, when you select any shape, you have to convert it into curves first. Right click, convert. Then using shape tool, you can convert it into any shape that you want. Now, what if I want to add, these are called the anchor points. So presently a rectangle has 4 anchor points by default. But what if I want to add an extra anchor point or point in the middle? Then it is very easy in CorelDRAW, because the shape tool is a 3-in-1 tool. You can simply double click on the outline, so a point will be added. And similarly, if you don't want this point or the anchor point, you can simply double click on that point, so it will get deleted. So it acts as 3-in-1. Why I'm saying 3-in-1? You can add, delete, and also you can change the shape of any object by using the shape tool. Look, double click, it will add, double click, add, and double click, it will also remove any unwanted anchor point. Now what if I want to change the straight line into a curve? I can simply click on this particular anchor point and I can use the options from the property bar that we will again discuss in some future videos. But for now, if you click over here, convert to curve, or you can simply press C. No, you have to click over here first. So it will be converted into a curve. And you will get these handles using which you can manipulate the shape as per your requirement. These are the handles. We also have some other properties that we are going to discuss in some future video, because it will get too much long. This video will get a bit longer. That's why I am not going to explain these options in this video. So you can convert it into a curve like this. And if you want to convert all the points at once, then you can simply select the entire object by using the shape tool, and you can simply click on the convert to curves. So all the points will be converted into curves. So you don't have to select them one by one. You can convert them at once together. And if you want to change them again to line, then let's say if I want to change these 4 lines into a line, then I'll just have to select these 4 lines, or the points, anchor point rather, and I can simply click on convert to line. And I think there is a shortcut key L. can also press L, so it will be again converted into a line. And if you want to convert them again into curve, then you can simply press here as many times as you want. So this is curve. Again, similar properties are applicable to ellipse. So this is an ellipse, and if I want to change, so these are basic properties without converting it, but if I press Ctrl Q or Command Q or right click, convert to curves, then I can simply again manipulate the shape as per my requirement, like this. So this is the shape option, which is highly used or frequently used, most frequently used tools, one of the most frequently used tools along with the pick tool. So that is how you can manipulate or change the shape of any object by using the shape tool and the pick tool. And you can also convert it into curves. Again, you can convert it into a straight line, and using these particular shapes we can create simple logos. So let me quickly give you one example. And remember, in CorelDRAW you cannot open a JPG or whatever image or photo, so you have to import it into CorelDRAW by using File, Import, and you can import any shape that you want. So I'm going to choose a simple logo. I'm going to go into this particular, so let's say if I want to use this one, so I can simply create a rectangle, convert to curves, Control Q, and I can simply match these points one by one. Remember, zoom in, zoom out is very important. I'm simply using my scroll button to zoom in and zoom out, as I mentioned earlier. So look, it's very easy. And what if I want to put this exact color into the shape that I have created? So you can simply choose this particular option, color eyedropper, and click on the color that you want, pick this color and apply it to this color. And I don't want outline, so you can simply right click over here. And we have three similar shapes, so instead of creating all the shapes, I have created one shape, and now I can simply copy this. There are a few ways to copy an object. You can simply click and drag and right click and leave the left mouse button, so it will be copied. Remember, click and drag, now right click without leaving the or without releasing the left mouse button. So presently I am pressing both the buttons, left as well as right mouse button. Now release the left mouse button, like this. Look, left, drag, right click together, and release the left mouse button, so it will get copied. There are other simple methods. Simply you can press plus on the keyboard, so it will get copied, or you can simply plus copied, or you can simply press Ctrl C or Command C, Ctrl V or Command V to copy paste. Whatever feels convenient to you, you can use one of these methods. Now I'm going to copy this, and if you want to rotate this shape, you can simply click on the middle center and you can rotate as per your requirement. So I'm rotating it, I'm placing it over here, just I want to make sure that it's perfect or okay. Now again I'm going to copy this particular right click, so I have copied. And if I want to flip this horizontally, we have both the options. You can vertically flip and horizontally flip, and I will match this over here. So look, very easily I have created this logo. But remember, this is a very simple logo to create or replicate. That's why it took me not much, it took me like few minutes only to create that particular logo. But if you have more like complex logo, then we will need to use some other methods or other tools as well. So but for now, using the shape tool, I have created this simple logo. So and we will, in the future videos, we will try to create some complex logos. So I think for the second Coral Draw class, this is enough. So do practice these steps, and I will see you in the next video. Until then, bye bye and cheers.